Hi folks, I'm Ian Baker, the product specialist with Camping World, and today we're going over the 2018 Jayco HummingBird 17BH. This is a front bunk lightweight model. Speaking of the front bunks, let's actually start right up here. So one of the things that I really like about Jayco is the fact that the bunks here, even though they're single bunks, are 300 pound weight capacity for sleeping. So that way, if you're an adult and you want to be able to sleep in here, you can easily do that. You'll also see you have curtains here for privacy, which is nice. The bottom bunk here, take a look at that, folks. Great storage right down there. That gives you access to your pass-through or your side storage right over there. If we take a look inside here, you'll notice a couple things. One, starting off on the bottom, you have a big door right there. That's great for storage. That way, if you're traveling down the road, you can actually lift this bunk up. It clips into place, and you can load this whole bottom area up with all sorts of great things. You'll also notice that you have an electrical outlet down there, an LED light, and a net. If we take a look up top here, you don't have a door. However, you do also have an electrical outlet up here. You also have a light there and a net too. So that way, again, you know, if you have kids with you, they want to be able to play on their cell phones or tablets, whatever it may be, especially on a rainy day, they can sit right up here and do so. If we take a look here, you'll notice a couple things. Right up top, you have the majority of your controls. This one does have a smaller kitchen slide out, so you'll have that there, awning right next to it, a couple lights, then your tank monitoring panel there too with your water pump and your water heater. Now notice something here, the water heater runs off both LP and electric, which is pretty cool. You can turn both those on at the same time for faster recovery, assuming you have shore power. Directly underneath that is your multimedia center. This unit is a radio, controls the speakers in here as well as the ones outside, and it's a DVD player. So if you want to watch a movie, pop it in right there and you can watch on the TV right below. Over to the side, a little bit of additional storage there. As I mentioned, TV is right down here. This one is on a swing arm mount. So if you want to swing this out and around to the kitchen, you can do so. There is another hookup for a TV in the back by the dinette. I'll show you that a little bit later. And then right down below, you have more storage there. Again, you kind of have a net built into the bottom. Another pretty cool thing is this right here. You'll notice that you have a table that is kind of stowed away right here. So great kind of storage spot. I think it's pretty neat they did that. Cool thing about this table, folks, is it is an indoor-outdoor table. So you can take it outside. If you don't have a picnic table, now you do. If you already got one, now you have another one. So it's pretty nice that it comes with it. Right up top here, coat hook. Great spot to come in, hang up your jackets right there if you want. Right up top here is your WineGuard Razor antenna. This is a low profile antenna. Cool thing about this one is you don't have to worry about raising it up or down. All you have to do is just turn it to find the best over the air signal there. Right over here, you have a hanging rod up top with removable shelves. So this gives you a couple different options here. The top two shelves are movable. This one is not. But it's great because, again, this is an excellent spot to store some of the clothes for the people that will be sleeping up front. Then directly beneath that is your direct vent furnace. Moving back a little more here, we get into the kitchen. So this is the slide out. Right up top is your convection microwave oven. That's great. It's a microwave. It's an oven all in one. If you've never used a convection oven before, I definitely recommend trying it out. It actually cooks faster, plus it's much easier to clean. Directly underneath that is your fridge with drop-down freezer compartment. Drop that down for you so you can see that right there. Folks, this unit does run off propane and electric, and it even has automatic switchover. So if you're running it off propane, you plug it into electric, it'll automatically switch over for you. Underneath, you know, they're maximizing all space. They wanted you to get some extra storage. They put in this big drawer right here, so I like that they did that. And then let's go right over here to the main kitchen countertop itself. So you do have a lot of space in the back right here. Now, while it's tough to use as prep space, it is a great spot for a coffee maker. You can put it right there, plug it in right back there. Two burner cooktop here and the sink up front as well. You also have storage up top. You can see that there. LED light here underneath and some more storage underneath. You have a little bit of storage right there. And then you do have a drawer here in the kitchen. So if it were me, it's where I'd put my silverware. If we take a look across the way here, I know we're kind of bouncing back and forth, but bear with me. So right there, you have another hanging rod up top, again, with two more removable shelves, just like we had in the back. So some great extra storage space. You know, if you don't need this for the people that are sleeping in the bunks, this does make a nice small coat closet. Right here is a spice rack. At least that's what I'd use it for. It's kind of, I think, what it is intended for. And then right here you have a paper towel holder and then some more hooks off to the side. Thermostat directly underneath that. And again, another little net right there, you know, for anything you want to store right there. Take a look directly above. This is your AC unit. It is roof-mounted AC. The controls for it are on the AC itself. And if we take a look in here, folks, this is the bathroom. This is a wet bath. So if you look, your shower pan is built into the floor. Nice and easy to use. You see the toilet right there, too. Kind of in front of that is your sink. The sink and the shower head are kind of built into the same faucet there. So if you need to use a shower, you just use the hand wand. The mount for it is right up top. You'll notice you have these guys right here, probably a good spot to be able to store your shampoo and your soap. Curtain right here, shower curtains. So that way, when you pull that across and make sure your door doesn't get wet, you have a vent in there too to quickly help moisture escape. And then right here in front, folks, is a big U-dinette, or in the back rather, I'm sorry. The bunks are in the front and the back is your large U-dinette. I like they have this in here, not so much for, you know, like having meals at, because the table is a little small. In all reality, you can probably, you know, fit a max of like 3, maybe 4 plates on here. But the reason I do like it is it just gives you a great spot to be able to sit and hang out. Especially with these right over here, you know, you can kind of sneak in like so. Be able to put your back up here, even if it's just the two of you. You can kind of put your feet up like this, be able to relax. And so, you know, for two people, I think this is perfect. And again, if you do have guests, you want to play a card game or something, you are still capable of doing that. You'll notice you have windows on both sides. The one is an emergency exit. Another window right here to let in natural light. You also have the net there, which is great for some extra storage. LED lights all around. And if we take a look right over here, you will notice that you have a spot right there for a TV. So if you do want another TV in here, that is where you'll mount it. Lastly, if you have guests that want to stay the night, this table does drop down. You can convert this into another sleeping space. Now that we've seen the insides, let's take a quick look at some of the outside features on the Jayco HummingBird 17BH. Right up front here, folks, is your power tongue jack. This makes it super simple to connect and disconnect from your tow vehicle because you don't have to do it manually. You just push a button. Also, you'll see you have an LED light right up front in case you're hooking up or disconnecting at night. And then around it, this little frame right here is what Lippert has named the jacket. Essentially what this is it is a front bike carrier, which is a great idea. There is another system that plugs right into here, another piece that plugs right into there that can hold a couple bikes on there, two bikes, and it can carry up to 100 pounds. The neat thing about that is, one, you're able to see your bikes, they're not hanging off the back, and also it frees up any other space in the back there for you. So I do think this is a great idea. I like the fact that Lippert came out with it. Right behind there, you have a 20-pound propane tank. There is a cover that comes with the unit. That is inside. I don't currently have it on there. And then further back behind that are your rails for your battery. You'll also see right down there, you have solar prep. So if you do want solar, all you have to do is buy the portable panels, plug it in right there, and it will begin to trickle charge. You have the black diamond plating right here to help protect the front end from some of the rocks and debris that get thrown up by your tow vehicle. And then your front end here, as you can see, is a big piece of fiberglass. Cool thing about the HummingBird, folks, is that this is one-piece fiberglass construction from the front here all the way up and over and down the back. So the big advantage of that is because it is one piece, there is less seams for water to penetrate, and the water will naturally want to run to the front and back again where you don't have those seams. So anything we can do to reduce the chance of water penetration is a good thing. We'll take a look at the front storage compartment here. If you take a look right in there, that is underneath that front bunk that I showed you. On the other side is the door. I can show you that when we get around to it. But again, great storage area right up front. Beneath that is one of your 4 stabilizer jacks. So after you get it leveled out, you will stabilize the camper too. Right here is a power awning. That's something you generally don't see on this style of RV. Usually they're manual awnings, if an awning at all. Sometimes it's a bag awning. So having the power awning on there is a great feature. It really simplifies things. Push a button to roll it out. Same thing to have it go right back in. Foldable grab handle instead of your standard one that's just right here. So nicer grab handle, comes out a little bit further. And then if you take a look right down below, you'll see you have 2 foldable aluminum steps. Aluminum, of course, is great because it won't rust out on you. If you notice this guy right here, folks, this is a mount for an outside TV. If you want a TV, you can mount it right there. You'll see your corresponding connections are right down here. Cable or satellite outlet, as well as your electrical outlet. Next to that is a speaker. You have one there, one here. If you want to jam out to some music, you can do so. Again, those are controlled by that multimedia center inside, but as I previously mentioned, that unit is Bluetooth capable. This one is the Baja Edition. If you take a look right here, you'll see you have larger tires. You have 15-inch tires on there with gorgeous aluminum rims. Again, those don't rust on you. And because it sits up higher, it gives you additional ground clearance. That way, if you plan on taking this off-road, not that you can go, you know, super far and start hitting jumps or anything, but again, it does give you that additional clearance and you have much more rugged tires, allowing for some more adventurous travels. And then right here in the back, not only do you have that great front storage, but take a look at this right back here, folks. This is underneath that rear dinette. You have more storage there. So even though this is a small RV, it is not small on storage. Coming around to the back here, you have an arm for a grill. This unit does come with the grill as well. That is inside. To connect, you will have a propane quick connect right there. So you can swing the grill out, plug it right into that propane quick connect, and it'll feed off that 20-pound bottle up front instead of having to bring your own. You'll also notice right here mounted on the bumper is your spare tire. I talked to you about the big advantage of having that jacket up front was the fact that you don't have to have a bike rack back here, and that allows you to have the grill back here. It also allows you to have the spare tire, which is, this is probably one of the easiest places to get to it. So I love when they're able to fit it on the bumper here. It also has this stylish cover, which not only looks great when going down the road, but also helps protect it from the elements. The bumper itself does have your end cap, so if you want, you can pop those off and you can store your sewer hose right in there. You'll also notice this is that window that was right above the dinette, but directly beneath that, folks, is backup camera prep. This is a smaller RV, but you know, if you're newer to RVing or maybe you don't have a great spotter or it's just you going out by yourself and you want a backup camera, no worries. Having the prep there makes it easier to have installed. So if you're having it professionally installed, that will save you money on labor. Your cable or satellite inlet will be right over here. And then you'll see right there, you have your 30-amp detachable power cord. Water heater right there, outside shower with hot and cold water access. And then directly beneath, you'll notice right there, that is one of your two terminations. That one is for your gray tank. The black tank is actually in front of the axle. I'll show you that in just a moment. Slide out right here, this is that kitchen slide. Built into that, folks, is the black tank flush. So this is really cool. Again, a lot of RVs this size do not have this feature. With the black tank flush, you know, a lot of people don't know this, but when you dump your black tank, a lot of times there's still some solids that are left in the bottom. This black tank flush, the sprayers are built into that black tank and it helps wash all that out so you have a much cleaner and better smelling black tank. When you come up front here, you will see right down there, that is your black tank valve there. Your two water connections are right up here. You have your city water and then right next door is the fresh water. And as I mentioned, folks, right here is that door. You can pop that open, lift up that bottom bunk, and you can store all sorts of things right in there. All right, folks, that wraps it up. Again, this is the 2018 Jayco HummingBird 17BH. This one is the Baja Edition. If you're interested in this travel trailer and you'd like price and availability, simply click on the link in the description below. Thanks again for watching. I'm Ian Baker, and let's go camping.